that the piston moves a small distance dx. Okay, so piston is moving from here to a forward location a small distance by dx. Now what is the force that is applied? So we know that pressure is equal to force by area. So I can say PA was the force which was applied, where A is the cross sectional area of that piston. Right? What is the distance moved? Dx. Dx is the displacement. So can I calculate what is the work done here? I know the force, I know the displacement. So I'll just use FdX. So here I'm referring a small amount of differential work as delta W. Okay. So delta W for this outward motion of piston, I'm referring as FdX. Is this okay to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Now let us see what it means. So FdX, can I write again as PA? Fm expanded as PA into dx. Right, from here. Now what this ADX can be written as?
Volume.
So I can say
volume.
PdV. Okay. So delta W is equal to PdV. So this is how we'll define work for a thermodynamic system. Okay, and this is capital W, this is for extensive property when mass is considered. If we talk about per unit mass massive intensive, I can write it like this, model delta W, and this is specific volume dV. Okay, so if you are given the total volume, you can use this form. If you have the specific volume, you can use this form. This will give you work done per unit mass of the gas or the fluid, whatever is there. Is this clear? Any questions on this? Fine. So this is how we define work in a thermodynamic process, PdV. This is the simplest form of work, which is called displacement work. Okay, so you could have electrical work or surface tension work, but in thermodynamics, we are generally referring to this work, which is called a PD work or displacement work. Okay, now let us look. So this is for a small change. Okay, what about a process? Let us say I have initial point as this P1, then this is the initial state. Now the system begins to expand and finally it reaches P2. So what will be the total work done here? So this is, let us say that the process looks like this. So it went from state 1 to state 2. So I want to find the work done during this process. Okay. So we, as we have defined in the last slide, we can say delta W is equal to PdV. dV is, this is all, I'm talking about intensive terms. Now, I can take a small slice here, okay, which is corresponding to dV. And here the pressure is constant. For a very small differential element, differential height, I can say this is my delta W. This is the delta W, which is done at pressure P and a small volume change dV. Integrate. So I can say integrate delta W from 1 to 2, which will be integrate PdV from 1 to 2. Okay, so this is the work done in intensity terms per unit mass basis from 1 to 2. This is the integration of PdV. Is everyone okay with this?
Sir, what is intensive and extensive terms?
Intensive we defined in the basics. Have you attended the previous classes?
Yes. Different or same that thing only.
Okay, so for example, we have okay, you need to go back to lecture slides of second chapter basics we talked about. So okay, let me go back a little bit.
No, intensive independent of mass and extensive.
Yes. So for example, let us say I have 5 kilogram of this gas. Okay, so if I have 5 kilogram, I will have some volume. If I have 10 kilogram, I have double the volume. So volume will change as per the mass. But if I talk about specific volume, okay, that will not change. It is volume per unit mass, which is actually reverse of density. So, for example, when I'm talking about work, so when I say W is equal to this much, this is per unit mass of, this is for 1 kilogram of gas. If I have, let's say, 10 kilogram of gas, then W will be the same, small W will be the same, but capital W, which is extensive, that will be 10 times. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Fine, please, I am uploading all my lecture slides and videos, so please refer to that. If you are not clear with the basic concepts, you will face more difficulty when we go going forward. Okay, so these were the building blocks which we discussed. Now, those assumptions or those concepts, I'll be using in most of the slides. Okay, moving on. So this is how we define work for a displacement process where the piston is displaced. So this is called displacement work. So this is also, there are different symbols used to denote work. You can write a delta like this or this, or okay, this is this print, let me just correct it. So we can also call, so we are going from 1 to 2, right? So we can say denote work by those two points. I can say work done from going from 1 to 2, or I can write like this, work done going from 1 to 2. Differential, this is, so these three are for, these three are for differential or small amount of work. These two are for differential or small amount of work. This could also denote small. But generally, if I know the process, if I know I'm going from 1 to 2, I can also use these two forms. So these are the more general form that we'll be following. Okay, so this is the standard form that I will follow in the subsequent slides. I will say W1 by 2 means I'm going from 1 to 2. And for that process, I want to calculate work done. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Moving on, now we know that work done is PdV. Now let us look at some of the properties or some of the basic assumptions here. So we have defined that integral of this gives the work done in the process 1 to 2. Now this is basically the area under this curve. If you look at this curve, if you draw, let me mark it for you. We get a different color. So if you take this curve, okay, if you draw or calculate the area under this curve, this will be the same as the integral. This is what is known as, this area is what is what will be calculated using this PdV. Okay, this, all this hashed area. So the area under the curve gives you work done. Okay, now a very important assumption here is that this process is quasi-static, then only I can integrate. If it is not quasi-static, I cannot integrate. Okay, from now onwards, this is our basic assumption. I will not state it explicitly for all the topics we study, but this is the underlying assumption that this process is quasi-static. Okay, now interestingly, because it depends on this curve, so whatever path I take, that will also determine what is my work done. If the path is different, then work done will be different. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Fine, we'll see, yes, some examples. So, okay, let us first define sign conventions. So what we take as positive and negative. So we see that our initial condition is V1, V1, where V1 is less than V2. And then the gas expanded and finally it goes to P2, V2. Now, we'll define a sign convention. Okay, some books follow this, some book follow other, but this is what we'll use for our class. So we say that if a system expands, okay, volume is increasing here, work done is positive. Okay, this is the work done by the system. Similarly, if the system is compressed, okay, if I go from this state to this state, I'm decreasing the volume, so work done will be negative, or work is done on the system. So this you should just remember that if it expands, then W is positive. If it is compressed, then W is negative. That is the sign convention that we're going to follow. Similarly for heat. Okay, heat we'll talk about in later slides, but let us define the sign convention for heat. So if I supply heat to the system, if heat is given to the system, then it is positive. If heat is taken out, you are cooling the system, then heat is negative, Q is negative. So this is the sign convention we are going to follow. Any doubt on this, or everyone is clear with that?
Clear. Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay, fine. Moving on. So let us talk about dead work done in a cycle. Okay, cycle means we are going from point 1 to 2 and we are coming back to point 1. So again, cycle we have defined in the basic concepts lecture. Now what will be the net work done? So if I take that PDM integration, I can say that I'll add both the work done. Okay, so I'll add path A, which is going from 1 to 2, because it is going forward from 1 to 2, I will integrate PDV. Similarly for path B is going from 2 to 1. It is the reverse process, right? 2 to 1. So I integrate from 2 to 1, which is path B. And if I add both of them, then I get net work done in this cycle. So I can change the sign. I can integrate from 1 to 2 and make it minus, right? I'm just doing it for convenience. I'm changing the sign and making it minus. This is a simple integration operation. Fine. Now, if you look at these two integrants, you can say that this is the area enclosed by the cycle. What will happen is the first integration that will give you the area under this curve A, path A. Whatever area is under this curve, that is given by path A, and path B is the area under this curve. Okay, area under B. Now we are subtracting this area. So this is the total area. You subtract this area, then what is left? You'll be left with, let me get a different color. Yeah, you'll be left with this area. Whatever the hashed area is there, which is inside the cycle. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Fine, so this is a important point. When we go to cycle, we'll just take the area which is enclosed inside the cycle, and that is your net work done in a particular cycle. Okay. Moving on. So net work done is enclosed in PV plot. That is also important. Not in any plot, but in if you talk about PV plot, then the area is giving you work done. Okay. So let us talk about point function and path function. What are they? So this is a process. Let us say any general process. We are going from 1 to 2. Okay. Now, if I integrate dV, let us take a function dV and integrate from 1 to 2. Will I get this or something else? For path A, let us say, if you integrate on any function, will you get delta V or anything else? Is this okay with everyone?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Now let us say we have another process. Let us say that is B, that has a different path. So I will calculate this integration again for that path also. So for path B, what it will be? Same or different?
Same, sir.
Yes. It will be delta V only. Basically, yes, integrating it. If you integrate dV, it will be V. So V to the V, 2 minus 1. V2 minus V1. Similarly, if you have any path with any random shape, okay, any random curve if you use, Similarly, you will get V2 minus V1. Everyone is okay with this?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we can say that integration of dv by integration of dv is independent of path. It only depends on point 1 and point 2. What is v1 and v2? That will give you integration. It does not depend on this path at all. Okay. So this we can say about any property. For example, pressure, temperature, they will also follow the same pattern. Now let us look at work. So we know that integration of PdV gives the work done. This is also the area under this curve. Okay. Now, the area under A, will it be same as area under B or C? Or will it be different?
Different.
Different.
Will it be different?
Yes, sir.
So the question is the work done same for all the paths or is it different? Can I write?
It will be different.
Different, sir.
Yes. So can I write this for volume? I have written dv is going to v2 minus v1. Can I write this for work?
No.
No. No, I cannot write.
No, sir.
Okay. So what we conclude is that work done is path dependent. It will depend on what path you choose. It will not only depend on the starting or finishing point. It also depends largely on what path you're going, A, B, or C, that will determine your work done. Okay. So, now we'll define. Work, we can say that it is a path function, okay, which depends on process path. Example is work done. Heat will also be a path function that will define in later slides, but this also is a path function. Okay. Now, if you have noticed, previously, that I am not using a simple DW. Okay, if you go back to those slides, we go back where I defined. Okay, if you notice here, this is not a simple differential DW. It is D with cut. So basically, this is called inexact differential. Okay. Let me come back to the, this is called inexact differential because you cannot integrate it simply. Okay, I cannot write dw is equal to w2 minus w1. This is wrong. This is inexact. I need to write in this way. So if you integrate, it will not be w2 minus, see, you cannot define w2. Work is, the work done is, you cannot define work for a particular point. Work is always a path. So you define work for a path, 1 to 2, what work was done. Fine. Similarly, we define point function. So this is, do not depend on path function or properties or quantities which do not depend on the process path. It is independent of the path. It is only dependent on initial and final stages. What is point 1 and point 2? That is what is determining your point function. Okay. For example, volume, pressure, temperature, density, all system properties. These are point functions. Okay. These are not path functions. And these are exact differentials. I can write in such a way. I can write dv, which is equal to v2 minus v1, which I cannot do it for work. Is this clear to everyone or any questions on this?
Clear, sir.
Yes, sir. Clear.
Clear, sir.
So another interesting thing I would just like to mention. So if you talk about a cycle, okay. So can anyone tell me what this symbol means? What this stands for?
Work done under cyclic process.
Closed integration means I am doing it over a cycle. Okay. So, if you integrate for a closed cycle, basically you are coming back, you start from 1, you went to 2, and then you come back to 1. So that will be 0 for any process, any property.
Yes, sir.
Because we are coming back to the initial point again. So for a closed cycle, differential dV will integrate to zero. And this will be true for any property. Whether you talk about pressure, temperature, volume, cyclic integral will be zero. But cyclic integral of path function will not be zero. Why? Because if you take a cyclic integral, this will be equal to the area in this hashed area. Cyclic integral will give you the work done in the particular cycle. That is not zero, right? You are clear with this?
Yes, sir.
So for any point function, cyclic integral will be zero. For any path function, which depends on path, this will not be zero. Okay? Moving on. So any questions? You have any class after this or should we stop? Can we go for five?
Yes, yes sir. We
can. No class. Okay. After this.
So I'll take five more minutes and I'll try to wind up this. Two, three more slides. So we'll look at some common processes. Okay, and we'll try to calculate what is the work done in that process. So this is an isobaric process, right? Pressure is constant, P1 is equal to P2. So what will be the work done if I integrate like this? And say, let us say this is P, so P delta V. That will be the work done for a isobaric process. Right?
Yes, sir.
So this is the equation that we'll use for all the processes. And we'll see how P varies for different processes, how pressure and volume varies. And based on that, we can integrate. Now here we see that pressure is constant. So I can take P out. I can say later this is P is constant. Then it will become dV from 1 to 2, which is V2 minus V1 or P delta V. This is for isobaric. Now let us look at isocolic process. So work done here, zero.
Zero.
P under the curve is zero. Fine. Everyone is okay with that? It should be zero.
Yes, sir.
Okay, moving on. Now let us talk about isothermal process where temperature is constant. So it will have some curve like this. Okay. So what is special about this? That temperature is constant. Now what about pressure and volume? Can I write PV is also constant?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Because P to nRT. So I'm holding the temperature constant. So PV should also be constant, right? Now I will make use of this. PV is going to constant while integrating this. Okay. So we say again the same equation what we have used. Now from this we know that we can say P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. Or I can say that this is equal to some general PV. Now I'll make use of this. I will say that at any point, pressure is equal to P1 V1 divided by volume at that point. Fine. I'm using PV as variables. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So I substitute this in this equation. I put instead of P, I write P1 V1 by V. Okay. Now I will integrate it. So P1, V1 are anyway constant. So it will come out from the integration. We are left with dV by V. Okay. What will be the integration of this?
LnV.
Oh, okay. It should be Ln and I will change it. So it will be P1, V1 log of basically natural log of V2 by V1. Right? Let me make correction right now. So let us say this is ln of V2 by V1, right? Similarly, can I, instead of V, can I write P here?
Yes, sir.
So I have made use of this because PV is constant. I replace V2 by V1 by P1 by V2. Okay, so this is for isothermal process. Work done, I can write. So based on what information is available, if volume is available, I can use this equation. If pressure is available, I can use this equation. So this is the work done for isothermal process where the temperature is constant. Everyone is clear with this calculation?
Yes, sir.
Fine. Moving on. So there is something called polytropic process. Okay. So what will happen is, for this process, PV to the power n is constant. Okay. So last slide, what we have, PV is equal to constant. Now we have PV to the power n is constant. Okay, so we'll again use the same. This is the basic equation. Okay, I'm sorry. If I'm not clear, just let me know. I'm having little cough, so voice is little bit of. Okay, so this is the basic equation that we'll use for all our calculations. Now we'll try to find pressure in terms of this equation. So again, we can write P1 V1 to the power n is equal to P2 V2 to the power n, right? Or I can use a general form, PV to the power n. Similarly, what we did in the last slide, similarly, I can write a general pressure in this form. Okay, so simply I substituted this, I moved it to the LHS. Is this clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
So now what we'll do next? Anyone, any questions were there?
No, sir. Okay, good.
So again, we'll do the same thing. We'll take this P and we'll substitute it here. Okay, so I can write work done in process 1 to 2 is equal to P1 V1 to the power n divided by this. This term we are replacing with instead of P. Okay, so for integration, I can take this outside of integral, because this is anyway constant, right? And then inside, what we have, V1 by V2, V1 to V2, dV to the power n. So this you know, right? How to integrate this? What will be the result of all this? Can I write it in this form?
Yes, sir.
So here we have V to the power minus n. I will add 1 and divide it by minus n plus 1. It goes from V1 to V2. So if you substitute this value, you will get something like this. Okay, so this, I leave you, leave this as an exercise. You should substitute it here and try to see how to get from here, from this term to this term. This is the homework for you. So try and get this. We'll talk about this in the next class tomorrow. Fine, we'll stop for today here.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Okay, any questions?
Thank you, sir.
What we have discussed?
Sir?
Any questions on what we have discussed today?
Sir, how to do in exact differential?
This is in exact differential only. What we're talking about is, okay, let me stop the recording first.